So I don't even know if I can give this game the introduction that it deserves. All I can say, everyone, is welcome at long last to BioShock Infinite. We've been waiting, some of you people have been waiting for this game along with me for the last 9 or 10 months. That's a pretty damn long time. You think about it, I could have had a child in that time. I didn't, thankfully. But yeah, I don't even think I can give this game an introduction that it deserves. All I can say is I hope you guys sit back, relax, throw your feet up and enjoy. This is easily going to be the most special series to ever feature on my channel. It's no secret that BioShock has been good to me. I would say BioShock 1 and 2 have gathered at least a couple of hundred subscribers to my channel. So I'm going to be giving this series 150 million bajillion percent, if that's even a word. Actually, you know what? I'm really excited for this. I was so excited. As soon as I got in the door, I fell up the stairs running up. I haven't fallen up the stairs in at least a month. That's how excited I was. So I'm going to stop rambling now. Just enjoy it, you handsome bastards and classy ladies.
Booker. Are you afraid of God?
No. But I'm afraid of you.
Are you going to just sit there?
As compared to what? Standing?
Not standing. Rowing.
Rowing? I planned on it.
So you expect me to shoulder
What's
the burden?
This?
No, but I do expect you to do all the rowing.
And why is that?
Coming here was your idea.
My idea?
I've made it very clear that I don't believe in the exercise.
The rowing?
No. Imagine that's wonderful exercise.
Then what?
The entire thought experiment.
Excuse me. How much longer?
One goes into an experiment knowing one could fail.
But one does not undertake an experiment knowing one has failed.
Can we get back to the rowing?
I suggest you do.
No,
or we're never going to get there.
No, I mean I'd greatly appreciate it if you would assist.
Perhaps you should ask him. I imagine he has a greater interest in getting there than I do.
I suppose he does, but there's no point in asking.
Why not?
Because he doesn't row.
He doesn't row?
No, he doesn't row.
Ah, I see what you mean.
Does she though? Does she see what he means? Anyways, look at that. Yet again in another BioShock game. They got another lighthouse for themselves. Alright, just want to thank you all for the lift. Oh, climb ladder. Up we get. I love how they call them a gentleman and a lady. They don't seem very gentlemanly or ladylike to me personally.
Shall we tell him when we'll be returning?
Would that change anything?
It might give him some comfort.
Well, at least that's something we can agree on.
Hey! Somebody meeting me here?
I'd certainly hope so.
It does seem like a dreadful place to be stranded.
She has a point.
Someone inside.
It does seem like a shithole to be stranded. Also, look at that guy powerhouse his way across the ocean floor. I don't know why he was complaining about to the lady. The man's a rowing machine. It's like he was designed to just row the boat. Alright, didn't expect to find some money. That's a good start anyway. If you've never watched any of my other BioShock videos, then let me just tell you. It's a little known fact that I have a tendency to be very poor in these games. Knock on door. You know what? I'll knock on that door in a minute. You can't tell me what to do. You're not my real dad. So guys, I can't tell you how... Oh, you know what? See that little menu that just appeared? Those little three circle things? That little inventory screen? I missed that. I miss that so much. But BioShock is by far one of the most atmospheric games that I've ever played. So just enjoy it. Just enjoy the ambiance. DeWitt, bring us the girl and wipe away the debt. This is your last chance. Signed in blood. Nice.
Excuse me. It's Booker DeWitt. I guess you're expecting me?
Of thy sins shall I wash thee. Use basin. First of all, though, I'm going to go explore. Because BioShock has always been one of the most atmospheric games that I've ever played. They're nothing short of brilliant. So I'm going to be doing a lot of wandering off, randomly, just so you know. I apologize for that if it gets to be too much.
Good luck with that, pal.
Very early signs of religious connotations. From Saddam shall I lead thee. I imagine that's a reference to Saddam and Gomorrah.
Is anyone here? Hello?
Which were destroyed in the Old Testament and the Bible, I do believe. I gotta say, already the graphics are hitting me. I like that song. Oh, use telephone. Hello? Hello? as an old school telephone as well. I like it. I would love to. Nothing but static. Be prepared. He's on his way. He must stop him. I would love to make an actual phone call on an old school telephone like that someday, though. Sink. Nice. Gotta turn it off, though. I don't want to rack up a huge water bill for that guy. Looks like there's some signs of a struggle. Definitely signs of a struggle. To thine own land shall I take thee. Oh, bloody handprint. I'm coming, buddy. I can help you. Okay, I can't help you. Sorry, I came with the best of intentions. My bad.
Shit.
Don't disappoint us. I kind of let that guy down, that's for sure. I'm just going to take his money. He might be dead, but I have no shame in taking his money. He's not going to be using it. I'm sure in life he would have wanted me to take it. Not sure if they stabbed him in the head. There's a lot of knives, but to me it looks like they just shot him. Kind of looks like they tortured him for a bit and then just put him down. Poor guy. But this little menu screen. God, I missed it. In the new Eden soil shall I plant thee. Yeah, so I'm going to make this first part. I'm going to make it as long as I can. I'm talking at least half an hour, but I want to aim for like the 40-45 minute mark. Just because it's BioShock and hello bells. It's brilliant. It's like they just mix my love of bells together. But yeah, I was not surprised when I saw that the game is starting off with a lighthouse. I've come to the conclusion that the guys on the BioShock team, there's got to be a few lighthouse enthusiasts in there. These bells.
Wait, man, that card.
Ah, oh, dude, okay, we have ourselves a riddle. Alright, so imagine that's how many times you ring each bell. Ding dong. Oh, what? What did I just... That's pretty graphics, though. Oh, I swear to God, if I just accidentally summon Cthulhu, the world is going to be pissed with me. What the hell? I guess it's communicating with Columbia somehow. Because Columbia, as we all know, is high above the sky. That's actually a little freaked out. The first BioShock game, which had a very creepy setting, didn't even creep me out half as much as this has.
Alright. Looks like they expect me to sit in their fancy chair.
And I bet you I'm not going to get my hair cut or get a nice pleasant hot shave. I bet you it's not going to happen.
So, what the hell?
Make yourself ready, Pilgrim. The bindings are there as a safeguard.
No, God damn it!
Attention. Ascension in the count of five. Count of four.
No.
Three. Two. One. Ascension. Ascension.
I just stay calm.
5,000 feet. 10,000 feet. 15,000 feet. Hallelujah.
Oh my god. Look at that. That is pretty damn amazing. I didn't even want to talk during that little flight. That was just pleasant. Why would he send a savior onto us? Look at the lighting effects. If we will not raise a finger for our own salvation. Do you hear that music? Mm-hmm. That is very soothing music, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of feel like I'm finding inner peace right now. Wow. The prophet shall lead the people to the new Eden. I gotta say, guys, I'm completely blown away by the graphics, the opening, and I don't know if it's just because I've been waiting for this game for so long, but I know a whole bunch of you guys have been waiting for this game for the longest time as well, so enjoy. I hope you guys love this series half as much as I know I'm gonna enjoy it. Look at this. This is going to be an amazing series. I already know. Oh, I can navigate. That's kind of an odd place to land a rocket chair, though. It's definitely a bit strange.
The seed of the prophet
shall sit the throne down and play on the mountains of man. Alright, so it looks like this. This is a pretty church. I mean, completely misguided. Completely off the mark entirely, but a pretty church. Nice architecture. Put it that way. Oh, hey, buddy.
Excuse me. Where am I?
Heaven, friend. Or as close as we'll see till Judgment Day.
Huh. I see. This definitely hits me as some sort of a cult, anyway. And in my womb...
such questions to myself, unless I want to get made.
Oh, confessions! Ooh, pick up silver. Don't mind if I do. Oh, great. Fuck it. Now I need to confess. I stole. Even worse, I need to confess. I did kind of enjoy it. I have no regrets. Alright, so Booker has been here for about 5 minutes. He probably doesn't even really know where he is or what he's doing, and he's already stealing from a church. My kind of guy, people. My kind of hero. And our first audio log, is it?
Love the prophet because he loves the sinner. Love the sinner because he is you. Without the sinner, what need is there for a redeemer? Grace has forgiveness.
Alright, I know I'm just kind of wandering around this level a little bit, because I think my objective is back that way. Sorry guys, I know I'm taking my time. But you know what? We've all waited for this game for long enough. So I say let's just take our time with it, huh? Let's just enjoy it. And hey, how often do we get to steal from churches? Is there a Big Daddy teddy bear in here? Oh, you know, I would love to see a Mr. Buggles teddy bear. Not a Mr. Buggles, Mr. Bubbles. Sorry. Buggles is the nickname myself and Jess have for our cat. Alright, so I got $42. Which, considering how much I've stolen from this church, doesn't seem like a lot of money. Considering I'm condemning my soul to hell, you think I'd sell my soul for a lot more than $42. Gladium. Oh, you know, I could run through this church easily if I wanted to. But why would I? I mean, this is pretty. This is the prettiest game that I've probably have ever done on my channel so far. It's unfortunate I can't record.
Year, on this day of days, we recommit ourselves to our city and to our prophet, Father Comstock. We recommit through sacrifice and the giving of thanks and by submerging ourselves in the sweet waters of baptism. And lo, if the prophet has struck down our enemies at wounded knee, and not railed against the Sodom beneath us, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just railed against the Sodom beneath us, but not accepted the 3 golden gifts of the founders, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just accepted the 3 golden gifts of the founders and not prayed for our deliverance, it would have been enough. If the prophet had only prayed for our deliverance and not led us to this new Eden, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just led us to the new Eden and not purged the vipers of the Orient, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just purged the vipers of the Orient, but not suffered the sacrifice of his beloved, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just suffered the sacrifice of his beloved, but not expelled the vox populi, it would have been enough.
Alright, this definitely hits me as a cult mentality kind of a place. Alright. Let me just interrupt your prayers for a moment, sorry.
Is it someone new? Someone from the Sodom below? newly come to Columbia to be washed clean before our prophet, our founders, and our lord.
I just need passage into the city.
Passage to the city. Brother, the only way to Columbia is through rebirth in the sweet waters of baptism. Will you be cleansed, brother?
I don't know.
I'm just looking to pass through.
I'm generally told to avoid cultists. It never goes well. It never goes well. You're not having my firstborn child. Can I accept baptism? Oh, I gotta do it.
Hey. I baptize you in the name of our prophet, in the name of our founders, and the name of our lord. I don't know, brothers and sisters, but this one doesn't look clean to me.
Who's there? Who's there?
Bring us the curb and wipe away the deck!
What do you want?
We had a deal, DeWitt. Open this door right now.
Told you. Not gonna do it.
Oh, come on. I was in the middle of being baptized, people. Have you no manners? I'm gonna come out there and I'm gonna kick the shit out of you, you little bastard. Oh. He brought an airship with him. What? That looked like New York City. I thought that giant statue was just pointing a gun at me. Don't move, bitch. Alright, I thought I recognized these people. Father Jefferson, Father Washington, Father Franklin. Alright, it seems to me like these people worship these presidents as gods. You can be damn sure that would never happen in Ireland, because none of our presidents or anything can be described as gods. They can only be described as pricks, really. Better love the air. No, he baptized me in water because he's fond of drowning people. He's a psychopath, except that. I like your pet raven, though. What does this guy have to say? I can't talk to him. Eat apple? Is it forbidden? No one's stopping me. Nom 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 nom. Oh, look at that. My health has gone down and everything. He legitimately tried to kill me.
With flaming sword and wings of angels.
Yeah, your leader tried to... he tried to drown me. Just want to point that out to you guys. Try to drown me. So that I may hold fast. What? Look at this. It's a hummingbird. Look at that. Hey, little buddy. We could be best friends. Well, fuck you too then if you don't want to talk to me. See, he makes it look like he's helping her out spiritually, but you can tell he just wants to tap that. Alright, there we go. Alright, we're all good. What's your story, Barosif? Broseidon? Only providence. And
that you see, it's divine. Just because the city flies don't mean it ain't got its fair share of fools. Alright. Still got a girl to find.
I'm not gonna lie, guys, there's a good chance I'm gonna end up wandering around an absolute crap ton in this. Hello, beauty! I could just look at this city all day. Also, that music kinda sounds definitely BioShock, you know? It's definitely BioShock music. My god, this is incredible. Also, you know one of the things that I prefer about this? Well, it's not that I prefer it. It's just a difference that I like. Is that... Ooh, chip. It's not even that I prefer it. It's just that, you know, it's a thriving, populated city. You know, these people are just going about their daily lives. Whereas with Rapture... Good evening, shopkeep. How much for the popcorn? Can I buy... I can just take this. No negative repercussions. And the hot dog. You're not even mad at me. Actually, he looks drunk. He knows himself. If he moves off that counter, he's going to collapse. Oh, who's this godly-looking fellow?
That statue, I just think it fails to capture Father Comstock's absolute, you know, divinity.
Divinity, sir, you are a man of great patience, because your wife is an idiot. Just pointing that out. Been here for like 10 minutes, already sold from a church and insulted a man's wife. All in a good day's work.
family and fatherland. I hope to be against all.
All right, let's take a look at what this shop has to offer here. I would look so pretty in that dress. I want it. I don't think I can afford it.
Never hire an artist, my dear fellow. They are a temperamental and unreliable lot to a man.
Uh-huh.
I told him that the park is exceedingly far behind.
All right, let's see what we got here. We got box phone.
And then the Archangel showed a vision. A city lighter than air. I asked her, why do you show this to me, Archangel? I'm not a strong man. I'm not a righteous man. I am not a holy man. And she told me the most remarkable thing. You're right, prophet. But if grace is within the grasp of one such as you, how can anyone else not see it in themselves?
Well, he seems like a bit of an ego dick. An ego dick.
This fox popular that.
It's a new word.
What does fox popular even mean, for heaven's sake?
It's Latin. It means...
Latin.
Oh, she seems like a high-maintenance bitch anyway. By the way, it means voice of the people. Just so you know. Just so you know. I got a whole bunch of other words that start with X as well. Not X, V! God, you confuse me. Gentlemen, how are you?
Good day, citizen. You're looking fit.
No homo. No homo. Lots of innocent homo. They're gonna be a cute couple when they're older. But this seems like a pretty narrow-minded society, so I don't think that kind of stuff goes down well. What the hell? Buddy, your horse has sparks shooting out of it. Now, I'm not a veterinarian, but I'm pretty sure that's generally bad when it comes to horses. Awesome horse, though. Awesome steed. Pretty awesome.
Good luck at the raffle, folks.
That's a raffle? This is like brilliant. Why didn't I randomly climb into a lighthouse rocket chair sooner? It brings you to awful, awesome places. Alright, don't think we got anything here that I can swipe. Do we? Oh, we got stuff I can swipe. I think that was cotton candy. Alright, Columbia, Raffle and Fair, 1912. I'm going for it. So if this game is set in 1912, I mean, obviously it's a prequel before BioShock and BioShock 2. I think BioShock 1 was set in the 1940s, and BioShock 2 was in the 1950s or 1960s. I could be mistaken, but I think that's right. So, I don't even know if they're going to bother sharing. I'm not even sure if they're even going to bother sharing the old BioShock universe with this game, you know? Like, I doubt Andrew Ryan is going to be popping up, or Fontaine. I mean, Andrew Ryan might just be born, maybe. Actually, most of the characters probably aren't even born. If Andrew Ryan has been born, he's probably like, I don't know, he's probably like 2 years old. And he's already set up 3 successful independent businesses and a successful hedge fund. The guy was born to be a businessman.
Would you care for a boutonniere? We're raising money for the girls.
Just buggering off because I got here. I feel like a social pariah. How can I help you? Can I buy some? Can I buy some of these flowers? Very Final Fantasy VII reference if I can, especially if your name is Ares. Good evening, lady. I'm gonna steal from your cash register. Oh, you have no money. She's pretend rich is what she is. Alright, little botanical garden here for us. I know I'm really going off the beaten track and wandering around a lot, but like I said earlier, we've all been waiting for this game long enough. So, you know, let's enjoy it.
One man goes into the waters of baptism, a different man comes out, born again. But who is that man who lies submerged? Perhaps that swimmer is both sinner and saint, until he is revealed onto the eyes of man.
Alright, so this game is definitely more religion-based than the last two BioShock games. The last two BioShock games were kind of like, not necessarily anti-religion, but you know, it was kind of like, people disregarded religion in favor of science and then thinking and whatnot. And then Bioshock 2 was kind of like cultist mentality, you know, had Sophia Lamb who could brainwash people into following her and believing that, you know, Eleanor was basically the Lamb, in other words, a Jesus kind of figure. It's a barbershop gang, barbershop band. There's something about those kind of bands that I'd love. I'd love to join them. It's not HIV, but rather full-blown AIDS. Not HIV, but rather full-blown AIDS. I'm sorry, I wish it could be something less serious. I gotta say, the lighting in this game, it's absolutely incredible. Oh, they're gonna totally hook up.
Faint and radical on me, John. I do not want to be some character out of I Married a Vox Populi. Now, do I?
I'm not entirely sure what to make of the people in this game.
Yeah, that's where they said I'd find her.
Telegram, Mr. DeWitt.
Huh.
Telegram for you, sir.
DeWitt, stop. Do not alert Comstock to your presence. Stop. Whatever you do, do not pick number 77. Stop. Tess.
Why did he keep telling me to stop? That was just rude. I wasn't even doing anything. Ooh, penny. Can I use it for this? Oh, we're using the telescope. Alright, nice. Giving us a bit of a closer view of everything. Although it doesn't really seem all that closer. We got... Look at that bullshit. He's right there. This isn't even a magnifying glass. It's not a magnifying lens. It's just a piece of glass in a metal tube. It doesn't enhance anything. Let's take that. Hey, hey, hey. A little less hanky-panky. He's old enough to be your father and you're young enough to be his daughter. And she's shoving you away. Stay right there. I'll get you a rape whistle. He's got nothing to say to me. There's nothing to say to me at all.
Good day to you, sir.
Hello.
Good day to you, my good sir. It's kind of odd, though, walking through a Bioshock inn that's so densely populated. It's weird. I'm waiting for these people to try to kill me. I'm waiting for them to pull out hooks and plasmids and... Or at least to give out to me for eating all their food, but no one seems to care. They just leave their crap lying around and... Oh. How close can we get to the edge? Jeez, you almost get vertigo. It's so convincing. Oh, look at that. This is something else. It really is. You gotta hand it to the guys who thought up. Like, they literally went complete opposite direction. They went from being on the ocean floor to going all the way up to the clouds. They literally went for the complete opposite. Can I eat this kid's popcorn? It would be brilliant if I could just take his popcorn. Absolute dick move. And I would love it. Gentlemen?
Through here, pal?
Streets closed for your safety, fella. They're prepping tonight's fireworks back there.
There's enough TNT back there to blow Peking to Kingdom Come. Again.
Roadblock. Better find another way around.
Alright, I'm really hoping to check out this Carnival slash Fun Fair slash Awesome Place. Murder of Crows. Vigors. Oh, Vigors!
Could hoist a one-ton stallion straight into the air. Would you
believe
me? Well, friends, I am here today to tell. Those are no
a life with vigor is a
those
life that's
no
bigger.
Tall tales told behind the pool hall. No, sir, no man.
That's pretty awesome.
Those are vigors I'm talking.
So I think vigors are basically the game's version of plasmids, which basically means Andrew Ryan completely ripped off the idea of vigors. That's a lawsuit
young
waiting
sir,
to happen. We're assuming Booker destroys all of we're assuming he destroys all of Colombia, just so that they couldn't bring up a lawsuit. Play Cast Out the Devil. Don't mind if I do. I was never a fan of that guy anyway. Protect the woman and child, hit the devil three times. That's all I want to use the vigor. Oh, I got him by accident. I was kind of aiming for the woman and the child. My bad. There we go, we got you. Alright, so I think this is basically a really clever vigor tutorial. Hoorah! We have a wiener?
Here you go. And remember, if you need it lifted, lofted, tossed, or tumbled, Bucking Bronco is your answer.
Being the mature commentator that I am, I'm going to comment on the fact that I have $69. Giggity giggity. Giggity goo. Anyways, I'm going to unleash my inner child for the next one, and I'm just going to play with some of these games. Sorry, guys, but let's just enjoy it for what it is, huh? Like I said, we've been waiting for this game long enough. Alright. I just need to shoot some things. One. Two. Three. Come on. Anytime I go to a fun fair, I think, in Ireland, you don't really have great fun fairs. We have one called Funderland, which is like average at best. But the only thing I ever won was I won a giant Speedy Bird teddy bear at a raffle before. Okay, are these guys all? Give me a moment. Oh no, they're not. Okay, for a second there, I thought that all of the caricatures were black. I was like, geez, this is really bad. But second place. That is bullshit. I demand a recount. Again, holy shit, it's a giant leprechaun. My fellow Irishman. More mechanical horses. It kind of reminds me of that horse from Final Fantasy X, whose name I cannot remember, and I certainly know I can't pronounce. Oh, we got a clown. Billy, how you doing? You gonna talk to me? God, it's like you've barely said two words to me since you became a mime. He's probably pissed at me because I killed Adam. Alright, let's see what we got going on here. Oh, I did it. Do I get anything? No, I just get the self-satisfaction of knowing that I'm an epic man-beast. Which is why any guy does a sledgehammer challenge. Let's be honest here. That's why anybody does that game.
The Vox Populi are on the loose. Who will hunt them down? Hey you, handy with a rifle? Looking to do your part for Colombia?
Sure, why not? I'm a long-time loving citizen of Colombia. Alright, we're going for 20 points to win. I want that man bag. I want that purse. It would look delightful hanging from my shoulder. Hit the targets. Hit Daisy Fitzroy. Who's Daisy? It's not exactly gentlemanly if I shoot her. Okay. So I think these games are all just... they're all just basically working as like a little tutorial to get you into the combat. Oh, I missed him. Did I hit her? Balls! I'm panicking. I'm not even shooting real targets and I'm panicking. It's because I know I'm getting points, that's the problem. Otherwise it'd be much more calm. Second place again! This carnival is bullshit, it's all rigged. Oh, hello. Here. How do I get here? Bucking Bronco. $375. No dice. I'm $89. I would have to play a shitload of hello. We'll check that out in a minute. First of all, I want to check out this delightful folk band. I like it. I want to join in. I want to fulfill my lifelong ambition of joining a folk band, but I can't. Let's check this out. I do believe this is a handyman. It's a handy manny. Not handy manny. Handy manny is a kid's show that my niece watches. If this was what Handy Manny looked like on the weekends, he's a lot more badass than the TV show lets him on. He's like, go mustache, bitches. Anyway, stop taking pictures. Can't you see? You're making the freak self-conscious. You know what? Fuck it. Let's poke the bear. Hey, buddy. Just gotta get a close-up of the guy. So these are basically BioShock Infinite's answer to the to Big Daddy's. They look... he actually looks like he's gonna be faster, stronger, and quicker than any Big Daddy. I'm about to just... without being able to justify it by saying he plays for...
Has a pay telephone ever refused to connect you with a beloved spouse? Well, it's time to take back control from the men of metal. With possession, you are the master. You will bend any machine to your will.
And all I have to do is drink this random green liquid that I have no idea what's in it? Shit, alright. Easy sale.
Just a whisper. They're all ears.
See, kids, this is why if a stranger offers you a strange-looking pill or bottle, you don't damn well drink it. Chances are, it is not going to give you the abilities to possess machines, and you are worse off for thinking it could.
Press to turn machines into allies.
Alright, so it kind of works like the security command plasmid. Yeah, it's basically security command. Oh, I just played the what in the fuck just happened to my what just happened to my ability to speak? It's like I just had a stroke. What's this guy's skill? You can play with a yo-yo. See, that's just not good value. That's not good. Look at this guy. Look at this little guy with his little tomahawk. Kicking the shit out of this little wooden thing. Clearly this guy is going to grow up to be a complete asshole. He's got issues. And no one's even giving him any attention. To be honest, they're better off. Now a midget with a yo-yo. That's what I'd pay money to see. Do I need to go through here?
Sorry, pal. The raffle is all sold out. Entrance is reserved for dignitaries and very important personages alone.
I'm guessing that don't mean me.
But I think I can bend this guy to my will.
Well, if it isn't Assemblyman Buford, your spot at the raffle awaits. Don't know why I didn't recognize you before. Odd. Always good to have gentlemen of your caliber at our fine fairgrounds.
I would love it if they had the T-1000. What was that, Arnold Schwarzenegger? The T-100? You're not coming through. Go on.
Heads.
Or tails.
Come on, let me through. Heads.
Or tails.
I don't think I can choose. I think I can just flip. I'm gonna go with heads, going by that guy's scoreboard.
Heads. Told you.
I never find that as satisfying as I'd imagined.
Chin up, there's always next time.
I suppose there is.
Those are the strangest couple. Oh, let's take a look at the results. Heads, 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 heads. Jesus, not a single tails. I'm sure there's probably more to that than I'm seeing, but... That was just odd. Those are the kind of people, those are kind of overbearing people you don't want to greet you. Oh, sorry. No, you don't want... Hey, come on, I want to pick up the chocolate. The money. The candy floss. Oh, full, full, full. Alright, so I'm kind of full up on everything. So it doesn't let you buy things unless you need it. Gentlemen? Done talking to you
look
all.
At that one. He looks lost. He looks just fine to me. Mary, you are a living, walking scandal.
Which is the polite way of saying you're a whore. Also, I just came to steal those peanuts. And the money from your basket. Now, good day.
This is.
They're just having a little bit of chat. Idle banter. How do I get too constructed? Too distracted? Listening to random dialogue going about the level. Like, I want to check out as much as I can, but within reason. What's this guy doing? What's he showing off?
This little beauty? The whole division got them.
Don't point it at me.
The box out of the Skyline system. We gotta have the best.
They got any openings in the group? I'd love to bust some Vox skull.
I like that thing. I like it a lot. But it looks a bit threatening. I don't like how he was just waving it about the place. Oh, look. What's going on up there? Huh. That statue was just shimmering. Now, I'm no architect. I've never sculpted a statue at all. I don't know the first thing about it. I'm no Michelangelo. But I'm pretty sure they shouldn't shimmer like that. Pretty sure that's generally bad. Is that a... Oh, it's not. It's a songbird teddy bear, I think. Yeah, it's a songbird teddy bear. For a second, I thought it was a big daddy.
Madame Lutess, I have read all your books on the sciences. Mama says it's not a fit occupation for a lady, but I think she's jealous of our cleverness. Is it true that only you are allowed to visit the girl in the tower? If the lamb is lonely too, I should like to meet her, as we would have much in common. Warmest regards. Constance.
Ah, that's quite nice. So yeah, the story also has a bit of a Rapunzel feel in that there's a woman, a damsel in distress, stuck in a tower in the clouds, guarded by a giant cyborg bird. Classic Rapunzel. That's an ominous looking hand.
What the
frack? You shall know the false shepherd by his merit. AD. I'm the false shepherd. Well, I imagine that's propaganda, but what does AD stand for? Because in our culture, excuse me, it means after the death of Christ. But, I mean, if it was AC, then you could say it's the Antichrist, but I imagine these people aren't too keen on Jesus, so I don't know, what does it stand for? The Anti-Dennis? Holy shit, I'm the Anti-Dennis. Also, I think it might be the devil. I think I might actually be the devil. And they say I would never achieve anything in my life. Ha! Policia, the fuzz, the pigs, the bacon. Police, do not cross. What are you gonna do about it? Huh? What are you gonna do if I cross this line? What are you gonna do? Oh. Okay, they're going to politely explain the situation and then send me on my way. I wanted to find out. They told me what they would do. Well, on everything. You know something? I'm a bit worried that this video might not be as eventful as I would like it to be. You know, I mean, considering we haven't actually killed anybody yet. In the first BioShock, you kill your first guy relatively early on. So I'm hoping we're building up to a nice gory kill or fight scene or something, but I think what it was they put so much effort into Columbia and creating the city and its people that they wanted you to have at least the first half hour to walk around and just experience it. I think we found the raffle.
The 1912 raffle has officially begun!
Mister! She seems to be guiding me over. What ho, strumpet!